Do you agree with me when I say this? Projects mentioned in your resume contribute 50% or even more than that towards success of your interview. Is this applicable to only data science interview? Of course not. Any technical interview, the resume, the project, and the way you are able to explain that project in the interview determines a lot about whether you will succeed or not succeed in that particular interview. Why are projects so important? As an interviewer, project gives me an overall idea of your understanding of the subject, your skill set, and most important, how beneficial you are for my organization. So this is how important project is. If we talk about data science, I receive a lot of questions from a lot of people that what should be the right projects in my resume? So should the answer be same for all, or it depends on some other things? That is what we will discuss in this video. Welcome to Unfold Data Science. This is Aman here and I am a data scientist. Let's start the discussion with understanding that there is no one for all solution when it comes to what project you should write in your resume. In this video, I will take three different portfolio, or to say three different backgrounds, and try to make you understand how do you select the right project for your resume if you are trying to get into the first data science job. Let's try to understand with an example of person A. So person A is working in some other field, for example, okay? So person A is a SAP developer or a Java person or a .NET person. So person A has like 5 years, 8 years, 10 years experience in these fields, okay? And now person A is trying to break into data science. So what should be the right projects for person A? Now to understand this, one thing that we should understand very clearly is there has to be an intersection between what you do now and what you aspire to do, okay? So there has to be an intersection between your current job role and data science. Now let's try to understand with an example. Let us say the person A works in retail domain, okay? Now if person A comes to me and asks, what project should I mention in my data science resume? I have learned data science from XYZ place. I know all the techniques. I have done certain use cases, certain projects. Now what project should I mention in my resume? So I will ask that person, in retail, what is the particular area you work in? So in retail, it can be inventory management, it can be campaign area, it can be marketing, it can be customer side of it. So which side of it in retail you work on? Let's say the person A works on inventory side of it. I am talking about the actual work of person A, whether he or she is a Java developer, .NET developer. So you are working on some data, right? So if that data is from inventory side of retail, then what can be the possible data science use cases in inventory management? So we should try to figure out what should be the possible use cases in inventory side of data science. It can be supply chain optimization, it can be inventory optimization, it can be a lot of other use cases. Now once we decide that this is about inventory, the next thing is we should get the data. Where from you get the data on which you work for the inventory analytics use case? There are a lot of resources available on internet where you can get the right data to work on. So I will create a separate video for that. Don't worry about this. First, let's try to understand at what level we should decide which project is more suitable for us. In this case, anything that talks about inventory management is more suitable for you. Why? I will tell you the answer towards end of this video. Let's take another person, okay? Let's take the example of a person who is MBA finance, okay? Now in MBA finance, you would have read about, let's say, loans, let's say credit cards, let's say different things in banking and financial systems, let's say insurance. Now out of all these area, which area is of your interest? Let's say insurance. Now in insurance, which particular kind of insurance you are more interested in? I'm assuming you are just passed out, you have not worked, okay? Which particular area of insurance interests you more? Is it person insurance or motor insurance or what kind of insurance? Now around that particular thing, what data is available in market or what use cases can be done? Now if we do little research, we will be able to come to some use cases on those lines. and then getting the data is no big deal. Okay, let us take the third example. If you are a student, if you are, let's say, engineering background student from mechanical engineering, okay, so obviously you would have learned automobile engines, all those things in your course. So you obviously know some things about how engine work, how different parts of motor work, how the assembly works, all these things you know. So in your case, you should go and search for a data science use case in automobile industry, and then try to find the right data, work on the data, and project that as your main project in your resume. Now, why I am telling you to be very specific and very granular when you choose the project? There are basically couple of reasons for that. So this comes from one of my interview experience. I was interviewing one candidate, okay? I was interviewing one candidate, and the candidate had mentioned a manufacturing project in the resume. And the first thing I asked him is, how many SKUs there? Now, SKU is a term specific to manufacturing industry, okay? So I just asked him, how many SKUs were there? And the person was blank. The reason for that is, if you take any project from any data or any use case from a domain about which you don't know, then you will not be able to talk in the interview. This is very, very important, guys. Please try to understand this. In an interview, the interviewer can ask you not only about your project, or it will not be a one-way communication, right? Interviewer can anytime stop you and ask you something else as well. Now imagine in case one, the person who was working in retail inventory, he or she is more or less aware of how inventory management works. He or she knows what kind of columns are there in inventory data. He or she knows what is the purpose of inventory management. So many things he or she will know when it comes to retail inventory management. So when interviewer goes little bit here and there from the main subject, you will be able to talk. Similarly, you can take example of the second use case and third use case as well. You will be able to talk. Whether you are MBA in finance, you can talk finance. If you are a mechanical engineer, you can talk automobile, right? This is one. The second point and very important point is, if you know few things about a particular domain, right? If I know things about finance domain, then there is something called feature engineering. All of you would have heard of this. The feature engineering is a process in data science pipeline where you need to create features based on your business understanding. Now imagine I do not know anything about airline industry or aircrafts, and tomorrow I go and try to work on an aircraft data. I do not know anything about that sector. Will I be able to do the good feature engineering? Will I able to think, or will I able to think more if that thing is from my domain, right? So there has to be an intersection between your domain and the project which you present as your main project, and obviously the work which you present as your main work. Most important benefits are, you will be able to talk more, and you will be able to do lot of analysis, lot of feature engineering on the same data, which you may not be able to do if the data comes from some other industry. Okay, this is how you choose which projects you should put in your resume, and what are the benefits of putting good projects or projects that makes more sense for you in your resume. My job here is to point you to the right resources where you get the projects which you should put in your resume, number one, and number two, where you should get the data to work on. For example, if I'm talking about retail inventory, I will point you to the right data for retail inventory. So in my next video, I will just guide you to how to find the right data to work on and how to refer to the nice projects to work on in that particular area. Let me know through comment how are you liking the video from Unfold Data Science. I'll see you all in the next video. Till then, stay safe and obviously take care.